channel. Looking forward to more comic book videos. It was never my intent to stop making comic book videos, but because I'm more of the creative type, I enjoy doing more creative type of videos, doing the different characters and things like that, the artistic type. But I'm going to start doing videos like this on the comic books at least once a month, and just go through my long boxes, which is what this is. For any of you who don't know, this is what's called a long box. It's a long corrugated cardboard box that's used to store comic books to keep them protected, mostly from light and air. It's not airtight or anything. And so that's it. So we're going to take a look at the comics that I was collecting towards the middle, towards later end of 2012, or for the most part 2012 overall. Most of these are DC comics. I'm a DC guy. I like Marvel too, but just ever since I grew up, when I first started collecting comics back in the 80s, I was hooked on DC. So that's just my preference. I like Marvel as well. I've collected Spider-Man, Captain America, the Avengers, Wolverine, so I like those equally as well, but I'm just a little bit more prone to or prefer the DC world. So we're just going to try to take our time and look at some of the comics that I was collecting before I stopped. So let's once you get comfortable, hopefully you already are comfortable, and we'll get started.
So
this particular relaunching, it's more of a retelling of Action Comics. It's about Superman and the first, it looks like the first dozen issues or so were by Grant Morrison. And I'm not a Grant Morrison expert, but he's done some amazing work. He's a very polar individual, I guess you could say, in the DC community. Some people love him, some people hate him. But he tends to really, he can make things complicated. He writes some good stories, but they can be pretty complex and pretty deep. But not always good, although the majority of people pretty much respect him. Anyway, Action Comics was basically, I'll show you some of the covers here as I talk about this. This was the retelling of Superman and how he got his powers, not necessarily telling his story all over again. It kind of starts off where he's a younger person, younger Superman, but he's not fully in control of all his powers, so to speak. He has a little trouble flying, if I can remember. But this was the first half dozen, the first six titles or so, I thought were, of this issue, were pretty good. And this is the debut of Steel. Steel is he's a person that served in the military, and he ends up creating like his own steel sort of robot to help fight alongside Superman. Again, I'm not an expert on the Superman mythos and all the characters. I'm not a huge Superman fan, but I wanted to collect this because it was unique. It was a relaunching, a retelling, and it was supposed to be well received, and I think it was for the most part. And this was a pretty good run until I stopped collecting at about issue 10 or so. And it kind of told the story of Superman and how he started off, pretty well not started off, he already had his powers, but how he pretty much became Superman and started off from there. I'm not doing it enough justice, but I also did not collect the main Superman title. I wasn't interested in that at all. I was mostly interested in the Grant Morrison run. And when I say run, that's a kind of a term that's used in the comic world by basically describing a series of comic book titles that could be a run from 1 to 50, just a series of titles, or it could be a run based on the particular writer or artist that was working on the title. Not all comic book artists and writers stay on a particular title for years and years. They jump around, sort of. This next collection collection of comics, this next run that I got into that I wish I didn't stop is American Vampire. This is a, and this has a price tag actually of how I have, of when I bought it from the comic book store in the back issues, how much I paid for it in US dollars. But American Vampire, you may have heard me or seen me talk about it in one of my previous comic book videos. It's real vampires. This is how vampires should have been told or written in comic book form. Let's see if I can put these down. There we go. And it tells the story of real vampires that have existed in the world. I don't know for how long, but they had different clans, different sects. Centers around one particular vampire who's a bit of a rebel, and it's him right here. And man, if I forgot his name, it'd be the death of me. I can't remember, but this is a lot of blood, a lot of gore, and it's how a vampire comic book should be written and drawn. Starts off somewhere in the Old West, and it actually goes through, I believe, World War I, World War II, up through the 60s. And again, like I said, I didn't start collecting this when it first came out. I found out about it about 2 years or so after it was already out, so I had to go back and pick up all the back issues, which is what you see here. These are all the issues that were already out that I had to pay above the price of what they sold for a little bit in order to catch up. So to speak, actually, I'm not sure. You know what? I can't remember now. I'm terrible. But this woman here, this girl here, young woman, I guess you could say, she ends up becoming a vampire, and she's part of the law enforcement, I think, or she's not, or I'm really terrible here, but. She ends up with a guy that's part of law enforcement, and he ends up getting bit. I think she bites him, or eventually he lets her bite him, so they can be together or whatever. And it's just great. It's gritty. If there's any kind of quote monster book to get, or any kind of comic book to get, American Vampire, you know, is the one. And let me open this up. So I'll try to make this maybe a bi-monthly series. Let me just show you some of the artwork. The artwork is just great. I probably showed, actually, this. Here's how some of the vampires are drawn. Exaggerated look to them. It makes makes them unique looking and terrifying. Written by Scott Snyder, who also wrote, I think, Sweet Tooth and Swamp Thing or Animal Man, one of them. But this is, if you're looking for to collect a comic, it's American Vampire. I really need to get back into this and pick this up again. Maybe I'll do just that. I'll pick up American Vampire again, maybe. And Hellboy. And maybe a couple DC titles, we'll see. Maybe I'll make a trip to the comic book store and just do a current pickup. Just to see what's out there. See, here's I'm not sure if that's Vietnam or World War II. The Vampires in the Army. So this is a great title. Definitely recommend it. And for any of you out there who currently collect, love to hear what you're reading. And I know some of you have suggested in the past certain titles for me to look into. If you want to do that again, that's fine. I'll try to get around to picking them up or look into them. This next particular comic is one of my all-time favorites. It is called Animal Man. Amazing story, amazing artwork, and a great character. How it was written before I stopped collecting. Written by Jeff Lemire, a great horror writer. One of the things that DC did is hire some more, I would say, well-established writers, but they tried to bring on board, I guess, some more writers with the experience that have written real books. I'm not really sure about Jeff Lemire beyond outside the comic book world, but that's one of the things that I think DC tried to do. And some just amazing comic books. This is a great title. Relaunching the retelling of Animal Man. It's about a superhero, but he's like a down-to-earth guy. He's a family guy. He has a daughter and a son and a wife. And this is the annual. This comes out. There's an annual issue for most titles. It comes out once a year. And sometimes an annual issue will kind of tell a different story, or it's hard to describe, but it's a yearly issue, kind of separate from the main storylines. Sometimes you'll have a couple of stories by different writers in there. Anyway, so this is number one, and you can see here, Animal Man, you see all this red. That red is basically the, what's called the red. It's the animal world. Anything that has blood, that lives, I guess you would say, in the animal kingdom. There's the red, the green, and I think the black, which is death. Green would be plants. And he has the power to anything that's in the animal kingdom. He has the ability to absorb their abilities. So, like, strength of an elephant, flight if there's birds around, No, it's, I think it's Lemire that writes it, and Foreman, Travel Foreman, that does the artwork, or it's Jeff Lemire doing both. I don't think so, but anyway, the artwork in these books is just, it's just great. It's amazing. It's a more of a horror type title. There is gore in it, but it's great story. And it's about the war between life, or the red, and death. And he has the power, he has the special powers I talked about. And he also has a daughter that has them too. But I don't think his son does. So, these are just some of the different covers. Some great stuff. Definitely recommend this one. If you, whether you collect it now, or and you're missing the back titles, or you don't collect it. It even has some crossover with Swamp Thing. Swamp Thing is in the green because he's a type of plant creature, and I'll get into that. He's going to be towards the end of the series. And so they kind of retold the story of Animal Man. The title, he's not a new character. He was a character that's been out for a while, but he wasn't on the shelves for years. And they, when DC did Blackest Night and Brightest Day, where, I'm not sure if you're familiar with that, basically it was DC's way of kind of bringing to life old characters through this storyline where the Green Lanterns that had the power rings, the green, cast of those characters. There's actually Death Lanterns. There's a whole spectrum, actually. And the Black Lanterns basically were trying to take over the universe and the world, and kind of DC's way of bringing to life new characters. And Animal Man was resurrected, so to speak. And I can show you, I'll show you some of the artwork in here. It's just phenomenal stuff. There you go. Some of that. It just reminds me very Lovecraftian. Here is Animal Man and Swamp Thing together. It's pretty awesome. Artwork. It's just beautiful. I don't know why I'm crazy for stop. Not collecting anymore, but it's a great title, and I highly recommend it. I'm not sure what Animal Man is up to now. Back to number zero, you see up here. went back to zero. And that's the time when I stopped collecting, not because of this, but I don't really know what the point of this was. From what DC was saying was that, if I can find it in here, I think they say it. Finish up here with Aquaman. I think I have Aquaman number one. For some reason, I don't have Aquaman number one right here. It might be in another box. DC also relaunched. Back Aquaman. Not sure how long he was off the shelves, but this is again another retelling of Aquaman, the king of Atlantis, I believe the king. And they fought, he was basically fighting these creatures from the deep. It was like this underwater, how do you want to say, like trench, I guess, crevice or crevasse, and all these strange humanoid type creatures came up from there. It was almost like Lovecraftian again, deep ones, so to speak. So Aquaman had to fight these, and yeah, food for the trench, and he had to, you know, go back down and kind of destroy the creatures and their like home, shut the trench, and he kind of did that sort of. Here's Mira, and Aquaman is decent comic written by Geoff Johns, who did, I think, Blackest Night and Green Lantern. Ivan Reyes, I believe, was the has decent, again, he can kind of, he has telepathy and has the ability to kind of communicate with sea creatures. He also fought Black Mantis, but I don't think he actually killed Black Mantis. I'd have to look into it. Let me see if I can show you some of the artwork here. I like the character a lot. That's actually going to do it for this session. And I enjoy the Aquaman title a lot. I would definitely recommend the relaunching of the new 52 of that title. So those titles so far, I definitely highly recommend. Episode, I'll just keep going through here and try to talk and explore some of the other comic books and the titles, mostly DC, and then like I said, I'll try to stop at a comic store and pick up a couple and see what's going on out there and read them, and maybe do that periodically. We'll see. Hope you enjoyed this video. For those of you out there, I know we didn't go over a lot of titles, but I kind of want to just do this in this format and see how it works out. So, thanks for watching, and until next time, keep reading if you currently collect, and if you don't, maybe we'll find something to pique your interest. I've also put some links in the description of this video to a website that's very resourceful and up to date with a lot of the happenings and goings on in the comic book world. So, as always, thanks for watching, thanks for your support, and until next time.